Hi, I'm Stu, and welcome back to another LumaFusion video tutorial. Today we're going to do a workflow technique, which is getting your LumaFusion project packages, be able to share them with the likes of myself if I'm helping you out with a particular technique, or you may be having issues and you need to send something to LumaTouch themselves. So let's get started. There are two ways that you can go about sharing. You can either share from the project window here, or you can share directly from inside a project. For example, if I tap on the share and export, go to LumaFusion project package, tap that, and then tap iOS share and airdrop. Tap that, and then from there, you want to usually share full original media, which is obviously a larger file, but if you are completely locked in with what you've actually cut and you're just wanting to show somebody a project, then you could use trim media, which is obviously going to be a smaller file. I generally send a bigger file, but it depends on your internet connection, where you are, what you're doing, and how much space you've got available to be able to do that. So we tap share, type in a name if you haven't already done so, and then from there, it's going to write the project, and then you can decide where you want to place it. Now, if you had an external drive, you want to basically save to files, and then go to the external drive, or in this case, I'm going to just drop it into my media folder, and we're going to call this video tutorial template demo. Tap done and tap save. That then saves it to that location. So if you're back in your project, you want to highlight the project, you want to share, and then just go through the same process. So that's LumaFusion project package, iOS share and airdrop. If you've got the space, file original media, and then tap the share, change the name if you need to, tap share again, and then choose where to save it to in your files. Now, when sharing to files and iCloud, you need to make sure that the actual zip file is uploaded. You're then going to tap and hold, and then from there, you're going to tap the share option, and then share file in iCloud. Tap that, and then go to your share options, and then I usually set it to anyone with the link rather than only people you invite. It gives you a little bit of flexibility. From there, you're going to choose how you're going to share it. Obviously, you can see all the app options here. I tend to just use copy link, and then that's it shared. Tap away from that. We can get rid of the files, and then if we just bring up a temporary window, and then there's the new file link, which gets automatically shortened in emails and stuff like that as well. If you send that via email, Twitter, text, whatever you want, where you want to communicate it across to somebody, they will then be able to download the file and import it directly into LumaFusion. Another option for sharing is WeTransfer.com. All you've got to do is go to WeTransfer.com, tap upload files, choose from files, go back to your most recent options. There's the file I want to send. Type in an email address, and I'll type in another email address. Message, hello. Here's your video project. And then tap transfer. There's a verification code that gets sent to you. So obviously, put in the verification code from your email and you're pretty much good to go. The reason I've created this workflow video tutorial today is because I've been in touch with some of you about sharing your video projects that you've been putting up on YouTube, Vimeo, that kind of thing. And I want you to be able to send me files as easily as possible. And that's what this video tutorial has been all about. So if you've enjoyed it, give it a thumbs up. If I've earned your subscription today, by all means, subscribe to the channel and I will catch you on the next one. See you later.